relaxing into a posture that is comfortable, dignified. You can close your eyes, close your mouth, breathe through your nose, or make completely different decisions about how to handle the eyes and the mouth and the breath based on what feels most comfortable for you. We come into stillness and quiet, but we are actually waking up to the aliveness within. Dropping the mind down into the body, taking up residence there. So bringing our attention fully to how the body feels moment to moment. Now for a sense of collectedness, focus, balance. Let's bring our attention in the body, specifically to the breath, wherever the breath is most evident. And feel the arising and passing away of inhales and exhales. Ever-changing, ever-evolving breath. Now bring your attention to the emotional body. In other words, whatever feelings or emotions are present in a given moment. Just as breath arises and passes away, so do emotions. Unaided by our giving them energy, emotions are thought to last in the mind only 90 seconds. Of course, most often we are perpetuating them, deepening them, growing them. Now we are relaxing back and simply watching the phenomena of emotions coming and going. There might be one dominant emotion, there might be several, they might be conflicting. What is the state of our emotional body? Feeling that for a few more moments. And now let's bring our mindful attention to our mind state, so our mental body, and see what's here now. Is the mind state busy or quiet, fractured or collected? murky or clear. It's helpful to imagine the mind state as being quite vast, open and spacious, making it easier to notice what arises and what passes away. You might think of thoughts as clouds passing by. Like emotions, if we do not engage with them, they're more likely to not evolve and progress and to simply pass away. So we've had a bit of a journey. We started in the body with the breath. We went to the heart, the emotional body. And then we went to the mind, the mental body. These three centers of being, or aspects of ourselves, are wonderful domains in which to practice mindfulness. Let's combine the three now and have a sense of wholeness. A human being with a body and a heart and a mind, mindfully aware of the exquisite interplay of sensations, feelings, emotions, thoughts. Settled and calm enough with a refined attention to notice this interplay on a subtle level. These are subtle energies. Not big, concrete thoughts or feelings that dominate, but what is below the grosser ways of operating. One of the purposes of getting in touch with this aliveness, this ever-changing interplay of phenomena in each moment within, is for the purpose of the insight of impermanence, getting a sense of how everything is always changing. There's nothing solid here to hold on to. And so we can finish our meditation with a bit of inquiry related to this insight of impermanence. Everything is impermanent. Our existence is ephemeral and not to be wasted. Every being who is born will die. Knowing this, knowing that we don't know the timing of our passing away, what is most important? Getting in touch with the values, the intentions, the aspirations, the passions within. What is most important? Is it family or love, connection, community, justice, safety. Everything that arises will pass away. What is most important now? And may we endeavor to live in alignment with what we feel is most true and important.